To say that Moto Guzzi and the Fiat 500 are two Italian motoring icons recognized worldwide is perhaps stating the obvious. But what if I told you that in the early 1960s a weird crossover between these two nearly happened? Buckle up as you are about to discover the secret story of the Moto Guzzi engine designed for the Fiat 500. Our story begins sometime in the late 1950s. Italy was going through a period of explosive economic growth, during which more and more people each year could afford to buy Fiat's new small cars, the 600 and the 500. But although the country as a whole was doing very well for itself, the same couldn't be said about the Italian motorcycle industry, which had to all but reinvent itself. Until then, the bulk of Moto Guzzi and the rest of the Italian motorbike industry's business had been selling small displacement bikes to those who could not afford an automobile, a market that, with the average Italian's rapidly increasing living standards, was quickly drying up. Moto Guzzi's technical department, headed by the engineer Giulio Cesare Carcano, got busy exploring new products and ventures for the company's future, one of which was a 90-degree V-twin engine designed in 1958 and meant to be tested on a Fiat 500 owned by the engineer Carcano himself. The idea was to somehow lure Fiat into offering a special, sporty version of the 500 equipped with engines supplied by Moto Guzzi. Designed to mount straight onto the Fiat's standard gearbox, the initial 500cc version of the Guzzi V-twin had roof-type combustion chambers with parallel valves. Following a successful trial period using Carcano's Fiat 500 as a testbed, the project then picked up momentum around 1960, when the engine was completely redesigned with hemispherical combustion chambers and saw its displacement growing to 550cc first, then up to 600cc in 1961. Fitted with a generous 34mm double choke Weber carburetor, the Moto Guzzi engine produced 27 horsepower at a heady 6000 rpm. It may not sound like much, but it was a substantial increase over the regular Fiat 500D engine, which was rated at just 17 horsepower at 4400 rpm. At this point, the motoring press had caught wind of Moto Guzzi's project, with the company openly discussing on the pages of Auto Italiana the idea of supplying between 10 to 40 engines a day to Fiat for a hypothetical high-performance derivative of the 500 capable of over 135 km per hour. By 1963, a new and improved version of Guzzi's V-twin was running at the factory's bench, producing up to 32 horsepower at 6000 rpm and performing so well once fitted to a Fiat 500D to convince Moto Guzzi's owner Enrico Parodi to finally get in touch with Fiat's boffins in Turin. Fiat tested the prototype for 3 months, after which it was returned to Moto Guzzi with a positive note about the car's performance, but nothing else. With Karl Abarth already covering the market for Go Faster Fiat derivatives with great success, it's fair to assume that Fiat's management had zero actual interest in dealing with Moto Guzzi, whose engine project was then consigned to the dustbin of history. But if you want to learn more about curious Italian motoring tales, check out one of the 2 videos appearing on your screen right now. See you next week.